All right, item number 16, groundwater and aquifer storage recovery monitoring well installations. Diana.
Good evening, Mayor, Council members. First of all, what is aquifer storage and recovery? It's the practice of storing drinking water in aquifers during times when excess water is available and then drawing the water later when supplies are limited. With the graphic that's shown on the screen, it shows a well in which you would inject treated water into a confined aquifer during times when you have excess water available. And then during times when you need water, particularly during the summer, you would be able to draw that water back up from the aquifer. And it the nice thing about aquifer storage recovery is that it creates a buffer zone between the groundwater and the treated water. And so you are strictly pulling your treated water back. And it's confined as long as everything aligns properly. So with that said, what's the benefit to Yuba City if we're able to proceed with the aquifer storage recovery project? This would allow us to maximize our winter water contracts, store the max amount of water that we can draw during the winter into the aquifer storage recovery well, and then during the summer months, pull from that to supplement our summer water supplies. We've had enough water, even with the drought, for these last few years with our current water contracts, where this would really assist us. If we had had this during the drought, we could have maximized our water, our winter contracts, to pull water during the summer, therefore extending the banked carryover water that we have. But where this would really assist us as we move forward to expand the city and provide water to more customers, it allows a more reliable year-round water supply. The purpose of the proposed monitoring wells is to define groundwater flow gradients at the site, so how quickly is the water moving and where is it moving to, enable further assessment of aquifer stratigraphy and groundwater quality, so are these aquifers truly confined, where it's the location of the confined aquifers, and then also what's the quality, is there a lot of arsenic, nitrates, metals, that type of thing. And then they would also allow us to provide long-term groundwater monitoring capability during operation of our standard, our production well at the plant, as well as an ASR well. So if we were to install an additional production well at the water treatment plant, do the two wells have any influence on each other? And this would help us to define what the, how far apart they should be set, that type of stuff. The scope of work under the West Yost contract would be to design three ASR monitoring wells at an anticipated depth of 410 feet. For reference purposes, the existing city production well is 473 feet, and we have an existing monitoring well, but it currently only extends to 235 feet. Prepare geologic and geophysical logs during drilling of each pilot hole. That would give us a sense of the type of soil that we're running into. Observe monitoring well construction, collect and analyze groundwater quality samples for general chemistry and metals, survey the wellhead elevations, and then prepare a well construction report documenting the as-built construction of the wells and the sampled groundwater quality. The total estimated project cost is $240,000. That includes the contractor going out and installing the three monitoring wells, as well as West Yost doing the pre-construction planning, the sampling during the construction, and then the post report. The schedule in total, it's anticipated to take approximately 5 months from execution of the contract, assuming that the contractor is available within that time frame. So pre-construction planning approximately 1 month, well construction development and sampling 2 months, and then the well construction report 2 months. So with that, the recommendation is to award a professional services agreement to West Yost for the installation of ASR monitoring wells in the amount of $240,000, with the finding that it is in the best interest of the city. So the next steps, once we install the monitoring wells, we determine the gradient of the water to determine if ASR wells are actually feasible. We would come back to council with the results of the monitoring wells and then make a recommendation as to whether or not we should move forward with the installation of an ASR well.
Let's take a look down the road and say that we aren't able to do the recovery, but then that we still get the benefit of having that second well to be able to draw from. Is that correct?
Well, with the monitoring wells, that would give us the ability to determine if we wanted to construct a production well what's the best aquifer to, you know, what's the best depth to install the production well, okay, and whether or not it would influence our current production well.
And then secondly, what would prevent, say, a property owner nearby of tapping into that aquifer that we are pumping water into and selling that water to somewhere else, Southern California?
Right. That's what's so important for us to determine the gradient, to make sure that the water's not moving you know, significantly off-site of our property, so that we have control over that treated groundwater or that treated water plume underneath the water treatment plant property.
All right. Thank you. Any other questions of staff?
Yes, I have some questions. So the three monitoring wells are being proposed right adjacent to the property we already have there, correct? Or
on site to the water treatment plant property.
It seems awful small of an area. So I just kind of wondering, because I know some of those underground aquifer lakes are quite large. And so I was just kind of wondering, that's pretty small. I know that the state of California loves the fact that we're going to be putting in monitoring wells because they like to have data. And that's been going on along a lot. Okay, for monitoring, that's fine.
All right. Any other questions or comments? All right. Entertain a motion.
Move to approve.
I have a motion and a second. Any further discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries unanimously.